I'm here at the WEGO booth with Evan, and he's going to tell us all about WEGO connectors.
Good morning, Bill. So today we're at the NECA show here in Las Vegas. We're showcasing our no-twist solutions. This is basically our solutions for any kind of twist connector. The first one I'd like to show you is our 221 series lever nut connector. So it's as easy as lifting up this lever, inserting your conductor in there, and you shut it back down, and you're done. There's no twisting, there's no taping, there's no crimping, there's nothing. This also comes with a carrier that you can put on a piece of in-rail, or you can also chassis mount it as well.
Tell us about this.
Yeah, this is the mounting carrier. This is an adapter. So if you have an application where you're using some kind of din rail, you can actually mount it, and I can show you a picture of what that, or show you an example of what that is. So you see your din rail here, you can actually mount your 221s with this adapter.
Okay.
So it can go vertically, it can go horizontally as well.
Uh-huh.
So it also comes with these individual carriers as well, if you'd like.
Okay.
So recently, as recent as last year, we came out with a new version of our 221. And this is our 10 gauge version. So this is a 10 to 20 gauge. These connectors are for 600 volts. This one goes to 30 amps, this one goes to 20 amps. Both are UL listed for UL 486C, which is a splicing connector certification.
And so what countries is that listed for?
That is for the United States and Canada, I believe.
Okay.
Canada has it a little bit different. It's the UL CSA. So, but it is certified in that country as well.
Okay, so tell us about the safety factors using WEGO connectors.
In every single one of these connectors, we have our cage clamp technology in there. So that basically, it creates a gas tight seal for the connector, so there's not gonna be any failures ever. So like I said, in every single one, there's gonna be a cage clamp. I think you might be able to see a little bit on the side there. So once you insert it, it actuates, it opens up that cage clamp. When you put your conductor in there and push it down, it will stay Loctite. So there will not be any failures because of that cage clamp.
Okay, some of my viewers say that they would never use these because they feel that the twist connectors are much better.
Mm-hmm.
Well, how do you feel about that?
I disagree full-heartedly. One of the nice things about this connector is, as you can see, it's completely transparent. This housing, you can see right through it. So you can see, when you insert your conductor, you can see that you have a tight connection every single time. If you're using a wire nut or twist kind of solution, you really can't see up there to see. It's transparent. You can see the connection every single time. It's kind of a dart, it's kind of a dart throw with twist kind of connectors, because you're hoping you're getting a connection when you're twisting it, but you don't know for sure.
Okay.
And when that happens, then failures can happen with the wire nuts.
What happens if one of those levers comes open just a little bit?
Just a little bit? If you just open that a little bit, it's still going to keep the connection. The only time...
Like that, see?
Yeah.
See, it's open just a little bit.
Right, I can show you. I'll get a piece of wire here. So if I insert this, put it down, it's going to be secure. Even if it's lifted up a little bit, it's still not going
yeah.
anywhere.
Yeah.
The only way that you can get that wire out is if you fully put the lever up and insert out.
That's right. Yeah,
awesome.
I know one of my viewers had that happen to him. So he tapes, or he loves the WEGOs,
mm-hmm.
but he doesn't like this if that comes up just a little bit.
But as you can see, I'm pulling as hard as I can on this, and it's not coming out.
Yeah, so he takes and uses electrical tape to go around it.
On these?
Yeah.
That's the nice thing about these 221s. You don't need any tape at all. You should not have to use any tape or any kind of twisting. Really nice, because they're absolutely reusable as well. So if you need to get that wire out, you need to do, just comes out and you can reinsert. You don't have to restrip. You don't have to do anything with these.
Some of my viewers feel that it's not as strong of a connection, because it's just like a backstab on a receptacle. So what do you say about that?
It's really different. It's all because of that cage clamp technology that we have in this connector that makes it so secure. And like I said, that's in our 10 gauge, and that's also in this one as well. So
it's totally different from backstabbing on a receptacle.
Yes.
Because that's just like a little spring.
That's right.
This is like a cage clamp.
That's a clamp. Absolutely.
Well, you don't got to sell me. I love it. But I definitely want to address viewers who prefer, you know, other connections.
Sure.
I have nothing against twist connections.
Mm-hmm.
I think those are fine too.
Right.
But I love these because you can see them.
Right.
You can turn them around. You can turn them around and see the backside, and you can actually see the connection.
Right.
That's what I like about them.
What's also nice about the 221, if you can see, there's a couple of different test ports that you can actually stick a probe in there to see if it's live or not. So you got one right here. You got one right here in the front. There's also a strip gauge. Get your wire up here and see exactly what you should strip your wire at. So this one is 11 millimeters, but it's just kind of a guide that kind of helps you out. So
when I first started using them, I did that, and then I've never done that again.
Yeah.
I just do it by eye.
Something I want to point out, and this we get this question a lot, on these connectors, you'll see that there is a UL symbol on here, but then a lot of people say, well, it only says it's rated to 450 volt. That's actually ENEC certification. That's a European, that's what their 221, that's what it can go up to. Here in the United States and per UL, it's 600 volt.
Okay, it's rated 600 volt.
Yes.
Okay.
And it also has a wire gauge on here. The only reason that doesn't say 600 volt is because it's just a small connector. We ran out of space, and per UL, that's all you need to have is that UL symbol on there.
Okay.
So just something to clarify, we get that question a lot. They look at these and they say, oh, I see 400 volt, or I see 300 volt. I thought you said it was 600. It is.
Okay.
Per UL 486C.
A lot of my viewers are actually live in Europe. And what kind of certifications do they have for Europe?
For the European, like I said, it's ENEC certification on those. And then there is also Chinese and I believe Japanese on here as well, certifications. The
It's all on there someplace?
Yeah, it's all on there.
Chinese, Japanese,
yep.
European?
I believe that's
American,
the Japanese. Yep.
Canadian?
Yep.
How about Mexico? Is it a Mexico one?
Absolutely. Not on the actual connector, but it is certified, yes, absolutely.
Very small print.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, so tell us the difference between the 10 gauge and the 12 gauge.
Really, the only difference is this connector right here. It's a little bit bigger in size.
I can see that.
Yep.
It's wider.
But the wire gauge on this is 20 to 10 gauge. It's still solid stranded and flexible wire, so 19 strand, 7 strand, and solid conductors. And that's really about it. This one is 30 amps, and this one is only 20, and that's because you know the 10 gauge carries that 30 amp max on it.
Okay, so here's your old ones here,
yep.
Right?
That's the original lever nut. That's our 222 series.
These are a little bigger.
A little bit,
these,
yes.
Make it more compact.
That's
in
right.
The box.
That's right. And these also come with a carrier that you can put on a piece of din rail. You can mount it on there, and like I said, they can go vertical. You can go horizontal, or if you want to, if you can get underneath here, you can do something like this with the screws. So you can actually screw that onto any surface.
Okay.
And same principle, lever up. Let's see if I can get this off. Lever up, insert your conductor, push down, and you're done.
I always
so
like
secure.
Those,
yes.
But I like these better.
Yes.
Yeah.
A little bit sleeker, you know, and what's really nice is like we talked about that transparent housing, you can actually see the actual conductor in there.
With the larger and larger devices that go in gang boxes, you know, there's all kinds of Wi-Fi devices and mm-hmm. so forth. You need to conserve as much space as possible.
That's right.
And this uses a lot of that space.
That's right.
All the twisted wire itself takes up space.
That's right.
And this, you don't need to twist. In fact, you're not supposed to twist.
Yeah.
Right?
You're not, no, there's no twisting,
No twist solutions.
You know, and when you think about it, look how easy it is just to take this off. You know, you strip your wire, and then you insert it, and you're done. How long did that take? 2 seconds? When you're using a twist connector, you know, first you have to twist it. It's not very ergonomically, you know, good for your wrists. And then you're twisting. And then a lot of times what they do is they tape it. There's none of that. You don't need nothing.
The other thing you can do is you can actually eliminate your big liveness pliers.
That's right.
You know?
Yep.
You might have something that's smaller that does some of the same functions.
Sure.
You know, like Klein's come out with a lot of smaller, they got a K120 3.5.
Okay.
It just has a half inch end on it
mm-hmm.
with a stripper.
Mm-hmm.
You just carry that. That's
yep.
all you need.
That's all you need.
If you use Legos, you can lighten up your load of your bag.
That's right.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
All right, so tell us about the new push wire connector.
Okay, so yeah, we have an existing push wire.
I'm very, very familiar
yes.
with it. I started with this like 30 years ago
mm-hmm.
in electrical. I used a ton of these.
Right. Yep, these are kind of an older product for us. Yeah. It's our push wire connectors for junction boxes,
yeah.
18 to 12
yeah.
Solid conductors. Like I said, these have been out for a while. We're actually coming out with a newer version of this in quarter four.
Yeah, let's talk about that.
This is kind of a successor to the 773 push wire connectors. The 773 is not going anywhere. They're going to coexist. But some things that are a little bit different between the two, as you can see, for instance, number one, just the size of these. So these are going to be about 30% smaller in size.
Oh, wow. This is both six connectors.
That's right. But it's a little bit smaller. So 30% smaller in size.
Yeah.
When these come out, they're going to have one of the best insertion forces on the market. So it's just going to be as easy as taking this, and it's going to slide in like butter. Is you can use flexible 19-strand wire in these connectors. So from 16 to 12 gauge. You couldn't do that with the 773. You could use 7-stranded wire. But this one will actually have the whole gamut, the solid, stranded, and flexible. Something that, you know, I want to point out too is, you know, Germany, we have our own laboratory, our own testing laboratory. So what we do is we do anything from, you know, these can't be in, you know, water applications. They can't just be, it's obviously needs to be in some kind of enclosure. So we do things like retention. So actually, how much force does it take to get a wire out of these things? We've done testing on those.
You guys are very thorough.
Yes, we are. Yeah. So we have a number of tests. You can actually find those tests from our WAGO channel on YouTube. But I think there's a retention one out there. There's a salt mist spray test. So it's kind of with the condensation. If there is any, how do they do? If there's any voltage droppage with that. And we do a vibration testing because, you know, a lot of times these will go into some kind of machine or something. And they have to make sure that even if there's vibration, that these are not going to fail. You can't really say that about a twist connector because they don't really do well in high vibration applications. But we do have testing.
You know, that would be a really good test.
Yeah.
Vibration.
Yes.
Because that's, you know, like I'm from San Diego, and we get earthquakes.
Right. Exactly.
Every once in a while.
You can't, when it comes to that, you can't take a chance on it. So what Germany has done is, like I said, they've come up with a number of different tests. In the laboratories, we have all that test data. If anyone ever needs any of that, just reach out to WAGO Customer Service, and we'd be happy to get that to them.
Okay. Say W-A-G-O.
WAGO.
WAGO, everyone, that's how it's said.
Yep, everyone thinks it's WAGO, and you can say whatever you want, but we at WAGO call it WAGO. Yeah, this has been a great show. We've had a lot of people come up and just say how much they appreciate the, you know how much thoroughness and what we, you know, what we put into our products, and we do. And we're always trying to innovate with our products. You know, we came out initially with this 221, but we wanted to make it better somehow. So what do? We went back to the drawing board. We said, well, let's make the lever a little bit easier to put up. Let's make it transparent so you can actually see the connection, which you can't do on this one. So with this 773 as well, we wanted to make it smaller so it could fit in more applications. We wanted to help the ease of the contractor to be able to push in that wire a little bit easier, and also when it comes to pulling it out as well. So
here's a question I've had from viewers: are these new WAGOs as tough as the older ones?
Absolutely. You know, when it comes, like I said, Jeremy does a very, very good job of making sure the quality that goes in these connectors is top notch, that we're not going to have any failures. It's going to be a great solution in basically any application that you can use a twist. So absolutely, they're both very durable, very great products.
Evan, thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet
Thanks
you.
Thanks for stopping by.
Thank you. I'll put links in my video description for the WAGO lever nuts in the 2, 3, and 5 connector sizes, both in the 12-gauge family and in the new 10-gauge family. I'll also put links for variety packs for both families. Thanks. I hope this video was helpful.
Driving down.
Thanks for watching.
So those contractors can help meet their 1025.